Wednesday, April 11th, in the year of our Lord, 2018. It is I, Morgan Wright, cybercrime dog extraordinaire Jack Bowers. You can tell because it's on the screen, just in case many of you get confused who's the dog and who's the talent here. Sometimes that gets confused. Hey, back at you. Kind of going to be veering off a little bit. Going to start giving you some ideas of what it is I'm working on, but one of them that's coming out is this whole concept of being a sheepdog. What does it mean to be a sheepdog parent? So I'm actually writing an essay on that right now, so I'll have that coming out, but it's a mindset. So I'm going to shift the mindset. I still love the benevolent dictator. By the way, sheepdogs are benevolent dictators. We don't vote on the safety of the flock. That's what the sheepdogs are there for. So just remember, wolves do not concern themselves with the opinions of sheep. That's why sheepdogs like me, like Jack Bauer, are necessary to help you in this world, that digital jungle out there that you need help navigating as a parent. So let's talk today something about, again, I never knew, you never know when you start some of these things about the hashtags and the lessons, but be the example is turning out to be basically a killer hashtag. And I'll tell you why, because every time I turn around, there is example after example of how parents should be setting the example for their children, and they're not. In fact, the studies that I'm going to share with you here in a little bit show that kids want parents to set the example. They want those boundaries. They want those guidelines. And guess what? When you do things, children model your behavior. And guess what they do? They do the same thing you did. You know, I want to be just like you, Dad. Cat Stevens, Cat in the Cradle. Remember that? All right. So that was my singing thing for today. So let's take a look. Let's go to, as they say, let's go to our other screen here and take a look at this. What your kids want to tell you about social media. So what are they telling you? Well, they did a survey. They did about 249 families, age 17, kids with 10 to 17-year-olds in their household. What kind of things did they learn? It was unbelievable. First of all, parents felt there should be no technology at all in certain situations. Like at mealtime, when your kid wants to have a conversation with you and you're in the middle of texting your best friend or going, OMG, OMG, did you see what so-and-so just did? Lose the phones, people. You know, phones down, heads up, eyes open, ears open, have that conversation with your kid. I've been guilty of this. Don't get me wrong. It's not condescending. I'm not preaching. I'm telling you. But as I see this stuff go on more and more, I even went to dinner last night, took my wife out, left the phone at home just because I could do it, just to prove that I didn't die. I had fear of missing out. No, everything was cool. Mexican food, it was great. Enjoyed it. Didn't have to worry about it, but it made me keenly aware of all the other people who go out to eat and miss the experience of the food, the friendships, the people around you that you're going with because you got your head in your phone. All right, so get your head out of your phone. What else do kids say? For example, and I brought this up, it is one of my biggest pet peeves. Quit texting in your vehicle for any reason. I was going into Fox News yesterday or the day before, Monday. Yep, Monday. And I have the luxury. I'm sitting in the back. They send a car for me because I am Morgan. This is Jack Bauer. They send a car for me, so I'm riding down there. And how many people do I see driving like this, holding the phone like this? How can you possibly do that? And guess what kids are saying? They're saying, guess what? Quit texting, even if you're at a red light. Nobody wants to see that, your kids. And guess what? If you do it, your kids will do it. Guess what else the kids say? They shouldn't quit oversharing, parents. Don't post stuff because you think it's going to be funny and it embarrasses your kid. Maybe this is a great time, especially in light of the Facebook hearings that are going on. By the way, it was on the radio twice today, WMAL and Sirius XM. And that was Monday at Fox News about talking about Facebook. It is about privacy more than it is anything else. Privacy is a policy issue. What is your policy on sharing stuff about your kids? If they consent, then hey, talk with them about this. Say, hey, it's okay to share as long as we talk about it. That's what kids want. Believe it or not, kids actually want those conversations. So what they're talking about is they expressed concerns about family members oversharing personal information about them on Facebook and other social media without permission. It's like I talked about in a previous episode, public shaming. Quit doing that. Discipline in private, praise in public, but don't overshare. And they said some of them found content embarrassing and felt frustrated when their parents continued to do so. What are you teaching your kids? That it's okay to bully people? It's okay to post stuff about them, things that will be privately embarrassed or personally embarrassing to them? So guys, just, hey, guess what? The research is there. That's what they're talking about. So the kids also indicated that family rules on technology work better when they're developed with input from both parents and children. Don't worry, folks. This link will be in the show notes today. So they use the word here. Kids tend to see this as hypocritical. When you are a do as they say, not as I do parent, you're not being a sheepdog parent. You're being a wolf. Quit being the wolf. Start being the sheepdog. And remember, denial is a is not a strategy. You cannot use denial. In fact, I actually have something really good written up here. What was I going to say about that? And actually, this is what I'm working on right now. So let me go back to my main screen here, and we will I'll pull this back up for you. But basically, there is no safety in denial. That's actually – so I'm writing this right now. So I'll put this out to you guys when I'm done. But it's taken from Lieutenant Dave Grossman. It's called On Sheep Wolves and Sheep Dogs. It was written after 9/11 in his book on combat, but it is a very instructive thing. This is why cops and firefighters and nurses and soldiers, why they do what they do, especially, you know, those in the line of fire. Because they're sheepdogs. This is what they were built for. Parents have to start becoming sheepdogs. Sheeps do not vote. Sheepdogs do not vote on the collective safety of the flock. They're there to protect the sheep, not to debate and to vote on the safety about it. So this is what it's going to mean to be a sheepdog parent. I'm going to start going into this a little bit more in the future. So we'll do that. So I'll talk about that. I'll send that stuff to you. But guys, remember, over here, up here, down here, depending on how you're viewing this or where you're viewing this, there will be a set of links, links to today's story. Remember, join our community, kids, teens, tweens, and tech. That name will be changing to Sheepdog Parents. I'm testing it out right now, but that's why I think that's where I'm going to go with the also with the podcast. So I'd love your feedback. Drop some comments in here. Share this with your friends. So I think this is how do you become a sheepdog parent? Because a sheepdog parent, sheepdogs do not make friends with the sheep. They're there to protect them. They are not there to be their best friend. You lose your focus when you start getting personally involved with the sheep. That is not a farm joke, so don't take it that way, unless you're from West Virginia. Just kidding. Anyway, so there are wolves out there, folks. Trust me, there are wolves out there, especially in this digital world. You need to stand between the wolf and the sheep. You are the sheepdog. You are the parent. Start becoming one, okay? So make sure you join the community. Guess what, guys? Save the date, April 26th. I won't tell you what it is yet, other than this will be great. I talked with the speaker. Save the date. I'll put out some more information. I'll actually put this out onto my page. Later, save the date, April 26th, 7:30 p.m. Eastern time. We're going to do our next webinar, and we're actually going to be talking about with a clinical psychologist, somebody who has a doctorate in this area that deals with families that deal with issues with technology and addiction and behaviors in kids. You guys are not going to want to miss this. So again, save the date, April 26th. More information will be coming out on that later, along with a link to where to register and get the information on the site. By the way, down below, get all your free stuff. Again, how to protect yourself on Facebook. I give you free courses there. Warrior Academy, protect 5-week course for that. Freepasswordcourse.com, save yourself. Guys, just I put a bunch of free stuff down there. Share this with your friends. But most importantly, folks, be the example. Quit texting while you're driving. Phones down, heads up, ears open, eyes forward. That's the way you have a conversation, not like this going, all right, so let's try doing that. Let's try being the example for our kids. I will have more for you on Friday. Until then, Morgan Wright, Jack Bauer, Cyberdog Extraordinaire. He will become the face of this, I believe, the face of the podcast and maybe a lot of the other stuff that I'm doing. I'm more telegenic, but man, if nobody cares about me, everybody says, where's Jack Bauer? So here's Jack Bauer. We'll be back at you on Friday.